one definite goal, to win your votes. You make the call. You decide the outcome. This is Singapore Idol. Hi, and welcome to Singapore Idol! Sorry, it's the National Day thing, I have to shout. Last week, Singapore voted, and we had to say farewell to Jane Lim. This is what happens when you don't vote enough for your idol. Remember, you are voting to keep your idol in the competition, because the one with the lowest number of votes will be eliminated. The power to decide their destiny lies in your hands. However, you can't decide the fate of these four people. Say hello to the Singapore Idol judges. Give it up for Dick Lee, Florence, Jacinta, Kenlin. Hello, judges. Judges are all set and ready. Let's check out the contestants. And for that, it's over to Daniel.
Hey, thanks a lot, Gurmit, and I tell you, these guys are absolutely ready. Singapore, please say hello to your idols one more time. It's Jasmine Tye, Mathilda D'Silva, Rahimah Rahim, Joakim Gomez, Nurul Maidin, Hady Mirza, Jonathan Leong, as well as Paul Twohill as well. All right, now, how are you guys doing?
Good.
Feeling it! They're feeling it. Now, the top eight had a real good time, well, busy time as well, throughout this past week. Check this out.
The idols went to the Singapore Repertory Theatre, where the rehearsal for the musical Forbidden City, Portrait of an Empress was held. And paying them a surprise visit was local singer Kit Chan, who plays the Empress.
Hello, I love you.
The idols were quick to tap into Kit's experience as a singer.
How important is an identity for former?
Having an identity, I think what's good is you're instantly recognizable. Okay, as a singer, I think having a unique tone. Okay, for example, like when you spoke immediately, I was like, oh, you know, that's a good voice.
They got valuable advice and a memento. At Cafe Cinelicia Orchard,
they're imitating the idols.
Now you see me, now you don't.
If you're gone, baby, time for you to come home.
Perhaps.
Nice.
The fans just couldn't get enough of idol action.
It's time for a break. When we come back, the idols will take the stage and your votes. Stay tuned.
New wave of stuff.
Oh, this is serious stuff. Hi, and welcome back to Singapore Idol. Here at Singapore Idol, we are celebrating National Day. So, 1, 2, 3. Happy 41st birthday, Singapore. Now, in conjunction with National Day, the theme for tonight is home, family, and friends. So the idols will be singing any song that conveys this theme. Now, they will also be sharing their memories of National Day celebrations. When they are performing, their voting numbers will appear at the bottom of your screen. Take it down, but do not call, do not SMS, do not vote until at the end of the show when we tell you the lines are open. For more details, check out our website at singaporeidol.com. Having said all that, I think we are all ready. Are we ready, guys? Yeah! I thought so. Daniel, let's bring on the first one. Alrighty, and I am with Rahimah Rahim. Okay, Rahimah, so what's your favorite national, you know, place to go to?
National place?
Yeah.
You know. The zoo.
Really?
The zoo.
Why do you like to go to the zoo?
I love animals.
Right. I thought you would like flowers. Maybe like the vendor is joking.
No.
Okay. Anyways, let's find out right now. what Rahimah and her family likes to do during National Day. Check this out.
Every year without fail, my whole family would watch the National Day Parade together on TV. After that, we head down to the Void Deck and play the Fire Sparklers. It really gets us into the mood of the celebration. When I first heard the song, I was moved to tears because I could feel the message of the song. Right now, I hope I can move all of you with my own rendition of Confessions of a Broken Heart.
This song is from Lindsay Lohan's second album called A Little More Personal, singing Confessions of a Broken Heart, Rahimah Rahim.
You know, you, I'm sure that song meant a lot to you, and you look very emotional when you sang it. But it's the first time I've heard you sing flat, and you sang flat almost all the way through. So too much emotion is not good. You know, you lose control of your singing. The style of song also, I think, something you like probably, but I don't think it has much appeal to the general public. Be careful about that sort of thing.
I'm going to absolutely disagree. I heard the audience keep quiet, which is unusual at the end of a song. I think they were stunned into silence by your emotions. That was intense and brooding, and I thought you brought that out very well.
Thank you. Rahimah, your intensity is great. Your passion always overrides your ability to make it not so technical. Okay. Happy National Day!
Happy National Day!
Rahimah, I didn't know what was that all about. You know, I think you're pretending to be a rocker again. Unfortunately, I still feel that you're not appropriate for this competition. But don't misunderstand me, I'm just cruel to be kind to you, because I'm being honest.
Okay, Rahimah.
Yeah?
So what do you say to the judges' comments, in general?
I have nothing to say, it's like... I can't say anything.
For a start, did you think your emotions went overboard and then you lost control of the pitching and the voice? I can still see tears in your eyes, which is kind of cool. People at home might not see this.
Yeah.
But the emotions were very strong. But did you think it went overboard and then you lost control of the pitching of the song?
Maybe.
Maybe a little bit?
Maybe. I should control my emotions!
You should control your emotions! You're not controlling it now! You're not controlling... Just when you say you want to control, you're not controlling! Okay. But you shouldn't control your SMSing and voting! You should call her now! Not now, actually, at the end of the show. Okay, her number is 1-900-112-1901. Or you can SMS the number 1 to 43657. Everybody, Rahimah Rahim. Daniel, next please. Well, next up, it's Jasmine Tye. Okay, Jasmine, I heard you fell ill during a particular national day. You know, could you tell us a little bit about it?
Okay, I remember we had a huge party at home and I had a fever of 40 degrees Celsius.
40?
Yeah, 40.
Ay, caramba.
Yeah, so as we were watching the parade on TV, I was being sponged and, you know, I had my eyes like swollen. But I had lots of fun, like playing with sparklers and everything.
Interesting. She was truly hot at that time. All right. Now, back in 2001, her family and herself went to NDP. Well, what was the experience like? Check this out.
I remember in 2001, my family and I, we actually went down to the parade and witnessed the whole thing. The atmosphere was electrifying. You felt so united and there was Kallang waves and everything. But my favorite part of the parade would be the fighter jets. Yeah. Every time when it flies by, right, all of us, my sisters and I, will be doing this, as we, you know, our eyes trail the pink smoke. And after that, right, my dad would be saying, so, you want to be a fighter pilot when you grow up? And all of us would be like, yes, we won, because it's so fast and it's so cool. This song, Don't Forget to Remember Me by Carrie Underwood, is actually about a girl being away from her family and pursuing her dreams. I can really identify with this song because it is what I'm going through right now, and I hope you guys can feel it too.
Don't Forget to Remember Me is the second country single from Carrie Underwood's debut album, Some Heart. Singing tonight for you, Jasmine Tye.
So many different guises, as a potato, cauliflower, cutie, cutie, cute. But this is the first time I've seen Jasmine, and I think it was really very nice. If you keep trying, sorry, just one last thing. If you keep trying and improving, you have a good chance. And if you don't improve, you can always be a fighter pilot.
No, I want to be a singer. Yes.
Jasmine, I wanna say you were good tonight, and you were good tonight. That was very nice.
Thank you so much, Florence.
I think you were always there. It's just that you finally found your groove, and you're a bit of a country singer. And you finally found a song which could breathe.
Thank you, darling.
I didn't think it was good at all. You know, Jasmine, every week you come here and you say you're going to work harder and you'll try harder, but every week it's deteriorating. I mean, it's not happening. So, I mean, obviously shows that what you have is not good enough. I think the way to go about this is to totally transform. Really transform. Right.
Okay, I'll keep that in mind. Thank you.
Cheers, everybody. So what do you think? Country is your kind of song, huh? Your style.
I'll have to work on it. I have to continue to hear and sing and practice. Yeah.
So Ken says totally transform. What if you had to like totally really make it like go 180 degrees and become this wild punk shaven head rocker?
Actually, I believe Ken means that, you know. Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
Ken means that, you know, I have to be comfortable with myself. You know, be someone that I'm comfortable with. Okay. Yeah.
Did you feel comfortable doing that song just now?
Yeah, I'm comfortable with that song, but I don't have to work on it still. Okay. I have to work. I mean, further on.
Okay. All right then. Then keep her here if you want her to work harder for you. And her number is 1-900-112-1902. Or you can SMS the number 2 to 43657.
Thank you.
Jasmine Tye, everybody. Dan, who's with you now?
Well, I'm standing next to Nurul as well as Joakim. And guess what? They're going to perform for you right after this break. Stay tuned to Idol on 5.
Welcome back to Singapore Idol. Now, if you want exclusive updates and juicy news about your idols on your mobile phone, then log on to singaporeidol.com to get more details. Right now, it's over to Dan.
Thanks a lot, Gervin. And it's Nurul. What is it about Singapore that you like the most?
Okay, I love Singapore a lot for many, many reasons, but two things that I really, really love about Singapore. One, food.
Yeah.
And two, the security. I mean, we take our security for granted, but I really, really am appreciative of how we're so protected and so safe.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's really great. I feel so comfortable and safe anywhere I go.
Truly underrated. Well, here's what she feels about the NTP. She recently went to the preview. Check this out.
Every year, I never ever get the chance to watch National Day Parade because I never ever get tickets. But when I did get to go with the other idols to National Day for the preview, right, I was so happy to be there. And then we had to go on stage to say hello to 60,000 people. My favorite part is, of course, the fireworks. They're so pretty. Yeah, 9th of August is very, very special to me because that's the day where I'm extra, extra, extra proud to be a Singaporean. When I was just a little girl, I watched the show Wizard of Oz and I fell in love with that movie. And in that show, right, the girl said there's no place like home and she shook her leg like that. And she burst into a song, Somewhere Over the Rainbow. And indeed, there really is no place like home. So I'm going to sing this song for you and I hope you enjoy it.
This song was specially written for Judy Garland in the musical The Wizard of Oz. It became a theme song. To sing it tonight, over the rainbow, please welcome Judy Garland. Sorry, Nurul Maidin.
I have to say that was like a lukewarm cup of tea with artificial sweetener. It lacked real soul and honesty. It was quite bland. And, you know, I know you're trying to put on this sweetie act with the little flouncy skirt and everything, but it's not you. It's just not you. You got to really go back, look back a bit to what you used to do. I think you'll find something there.
Thanks, Dick. I'm going to keep it short, Nurul. That was very sweet, but bland.
Okay, thank you.
I loved it, but I think it was a bit... It was a little heavy in parts on your voice, so you've got to watch that.
Okay, we'll roger that.
You know, you're young. You should relate to stars like Joss Stone and maybe Nelly Furtado. But your impression on stage gives me that impression that you want to be like Judy Garland and Jacinta Abisheganaghadan.
Which is a good thing, right?
You know, no, not that it's a bad thing, but it just assisted you to be dull and jaded, you see?
Right. Thank you.
No rule, everybody. What are you going to say about the comments?
I'll work at everything they say.
You want more, sorry?
I'll work hard.
You work hard on everything they say.
And take the comments and, you know, learn and... work at it.
So are you the Joss Stone kind of person? Or are you like more like the Judy Garland? Are you like maybe a classic at heart?
I think all of the above.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I try to adapt everybody's good points and bad points and, you know, be something. But it's all me anyways.
Cool. So. All right then. Yeah. If you want to keep in the competition, then...
Like,
sorry, what? Yes?
Quite schizo.
You're quite schizo.
No,
if you want to keep this schizo in the competition, her schizophrenic number is 1-900-112-1903. Or you can SMS the number 3 to 43657. Everybody, this is Nurul. Dan, to you. Thanks a lot, Dermot. We're just holding that. Coming up next, it's Joakim Gomez. All right, Joakim, what's your favorite place in Singapore?
It has to be the Esplanade.
What?
Can see fireworks, huh?
Right, the place of the durian, all right. This is a very special national day that Joakim will never forget. Here's why.
The national day I remember most is the year 2004. That was when I was dressed up as a Eurasian kid and I got to meet Mr. Lee Hsien Loong before he became Prime Minister. I was supposed to talk about all the Eurasians in Singapore who made a difference, like Benjamin Sheares and stuff. It was really very, very humbling experience to meet Mr. Lee Hsien Loong before he became Prime Minister. It's really very, it's an honour to meet him. I always remember that day. Tonight, I picked the song, I'll Be There For You. It's from the TV show Friends. So I just want to say thank you all for being there for me. And tonight, I'll be there for you.
I'll Be There For You was initially not in the album LP that the Rembrandts released in 1995. But a last-minute decision was made to put it in. Wise decision. Singing tonight, please welcome Joakim Gomez.
Rock the house. So no one told you life was gonna be this way. Job's a joke, you're broke. But love lies the away. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. Well, it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year. But I'll be there for you when the rain starts to pour. I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. Cause you're there for me too. Your breakfast so far, things are going great. Your mother warned you there'd be days like these. But she didn't tell you when the world has brought you down to your knees. But I'll be there for you when the rain starts to pour. I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. Cause you're there for me too.
You know, I've been there for you all the way until now. You look so strange tonight, like a cross between a cowboy and a petrol pump attendant. The song, okay, is nice, bouncy and all that, but I, as I watch you week after week, I have to look beyond all of that, okay? So, the singing is really sucks, lah. you're so nice to watch, but the singing, where's the singing? You have to get singing lessons or something. I don't know what you gotta do.
Alrighty, Joakim. Tonight, you definitely need your friends, family, and fans to vote you in. That was a school concert rendition of Friends.
Okay.
Didn't work at all.
Okay.
Yeah, I think you've got to watch your pitching.
Okay.
But you pick deceptively easy songs. They're not that easy to sing.
Okay.
So I know that.
Okay.
If you don't mind, Ken.
Well, the good thing is you didn't sound like Ja. Okay. Anyway, Joakim, I think you have inflicted us with an allergy to your singing ability.
Okay.
Okay, I think you know that by now. That miracle has not happened yet. I don't think it will ever happen.
Okay. Joakim, everybody. Okay, so Joakim, what have you got to say? Can I move a bit to the center? Thank you very much. What have you got to say about the judges?
Happy National Day.
Happy National Day, that's all you got to say. Okay, well then we'll keep it short and sweet. I know all of you are waiting to find out his number, so I'll step aside. And this is his number. It is 1-900-112-1904. Or you can SMS number 4 to 43657.
Okay.
Joakim, everybody. Dan, back to you. All right, now coming up next, it's Mathilda as well as Hady. They're next on Idol. It will be the first few to win tickets to the final, Singapore Idol Finals that is, in September. Then all you have to do is send your entries in the banner making competition. You can also win tickets to Spectaculars and meet your idols up close. For more details, check our website, singaporeidol.com. Simple as that. Now, let's get the competition going and going and going. And for that, it is for Daniel. Over to Daniel.
All right, thanks a lot. I'm with Mathilda D'Silva, who's up next.
Okay, Mathilda. Let's say there is a tourist.
Mm-hmm.
Where would you take this tourist to in Singapore and why?
Well, actually, I've been approached by a few tourists and I think the one thing that they've always been trying to see is local music. So I'd be bringing, like, you know, tourists to local gigs and stuff and just get them to feel, like, you know, the music that we produce, which is, of course, very, very good.
Well said, I must say.
Yeah.
Now, here's what Mathilda likes to do every single National Day. Check this out.
Usually for National Day, me and my family will kind of gather around the telly and we'll have a big cookout and we'll just watch the parade.
I've always dreamed of actually being, you know, either in the Padang or in the stadium and watching everything. And especially like the whole Majula Singapura, you see everybody singing with gusto. It's like this amazing moment.
I'm going to be doing the song In the Living Years by Mike and the Mechanics. My dad lost his dad when he was very, very young, and ever since then there have been very few records or even photographs of his father. And I think there were a lot of things that he wanted to tell his dad that he never got the chance to say. And I'm lucky in a sense because now I had the chance to tell my dad just how much I love him. And I would love to share that with you guys.
Save me. This song by Mike and the Mechanics was written by lead guitarist Paul Rutherford. It's about the conflict he had with his father. Singing The Living Years is Mathilda D'Silva.
Wasn't there that morning when my father passed away? I didn't get to tell him all the things I had to say. I know that I'm a prisoner to one my father held so dear. I know that I'm a hostage to all his hopes and fears. I just wish I could have told him in the living years. So say it, say it, say it loud. Come on, you say.
To admit
Okay. I'm not going to talk about your singing because it's almost perfect. But I do think it's time for you now to work on your audience appeal, especially the audience at home, okay? It's hard to judge by the audience here because, you know, they're all excited and they all love you. But the ones at home need to like you too. And I think you put so much into your singing, it comes across as very angry all the time. Okay, I've never seen you once be happy singing. You know, maybe you should work on that a bit.
Okay, I will. Thanks. Mathilda, week after week, you come on stage and you just kill us with your delivery. Tonight, I felt you just, you know, fell short a little because you tried a little bit too hard. Still, there's no doubt in my mind you have the best voice in this competition and you will have a singing career. Thank you.
It was a very nice and easy start. It got a bit frenetic at the end. So you've got to watch that. But you communicated to us.
Thanks, Jeff.
It's no secret that you do, I mean, that you don't have the X factor. It's very obvious. So you're solely dependent on your vocals in this competition. So I expect no less than excellence. But today it didn't happen.
Okay, thank you.
So what to you? Were you singing without any meaning or were you trying to put a meaning across and touching the people at home?
I think most of the time I was just looking in that direction at my dad, so...
Yeah. Where's your dad? Where's dad?
He's right there.
Hey, hello, uncle. Hello, uncle.
So I was trying to talk to him and talk to everyone at home as well.
Coming back to what Dick said, can you sing happy songs and be happy?
Yeah, I know. Well, I think, like, you know, today, like, there's a lot of constructive criticism and I'm just like, wow, actually I'm happy.
Yeah.
Now I'm happy. Now I'm like, yeah, okay, I've got stuff okay. I can work on. Yeah, I got homework.
Okay, if you're happy with Mathilda, then take her number down. It is 1-900-112-1905. Or you can SMS the number 5 to 43657. Mathilda, everybody. Dan, next one, please. All right, next up, it's Hady Mirza.
Hi. All right, Hady, now you do a certain activity prior to National Day every single year. What is it?
Okay, in the spirit of patriotism and our nation's love for soccer, me and my friends, we play street soccer.
Right, yeah. Before the National Day.
That's right.
In case you get injured, got a holiday.
That's right.
Interesting. Now, for him, of course, National Day is a family affair. Here's what he fondly remembers about it.
I remember when I was young, my whole family, including my grandmother and also my late grandfather, we always make it a point to watch National Day Parade live at the location itself, be it at National Stadium or at the Padang. We had to queue up for the tickets overnight and we had to pitch up tents and all that. So it was really quite an experience. But the big payoff is definitely getting to watch the show live at the location. I remember the sun will come down and all the lights will come out. And at the end of the show, the fireworks display is just awesome. I will be doing You've Got a Friend because this song reminds me of my friends and how important they are in my life. You know, when I'm down, I always have my friends to cheer me up. And this song will go out to all my friends and you guys out there.
This song has been performed many times by many artists, including Carole King, James Taylor, Michael Jackson. Here to sing You've Got a Friend, Hady Mirza.
When you're down and trouble and you need some love and care and nothing, no, nothing is going right, just close your eyes.
You really got me in your, you know, I was so captivated by your performance, I forgot to think what to say. Which is a good thing. You know, you always choose really good songs. So I think that is something, well, the other contestants need to follow your example. You choose a good song, you perform it well, and we get lost in your performance. I think that's what it's all about. Thank you.
I'll have to admit, I was a bit worried for you because initially you started off almost too sweet and a bit boring. But midway through the song, you kicked it in and then that was fine. Then you were good.
Thank you, Flores.
I really love a singer who's very relaxed in his own thing or her own thing. No, no, you didn't look nervous at all. And you gave us a rendition which was fresh and you communicated your friendship.
Thank you, John.
Hady, that performance is a dime in a dozen, nothing much. You are capable of doing better. You know, you have to find that spark. You're going to make yourself fabulous. You haven't reached it yet.
I'm trying, okay, I'm trying. Hady! Okay, Hady, how do you feel?
I feel good. I like the song, so I sang it the way I wanted to. And
you agree with Ken that you have still got more to give?
I'm afraid I have to say that I agree with him.
Cool. Yeah, okay. So you have to keep him in the competition to see more of him if you want to see more of him. And to see more of him, you got to get his number down. It is, check this out, 1-900-112-1906. Or you can SMS the number 6 to 43657. Everybody, Hady Mirza. You realize now that Jacinta and Ken are not talking to each other anymore. So we'll take a short break. Dan, what say you? I say a break is a good idea so that they can patch things up. In the meantime, coming up next, 6 down, 2 to go, it's Paul and Jonathan up next on Idol. Welcome back to Singapore Idol. Now, if you like the song sung by the Idol and you want it downloaded on your phone as a ringtone, you can check our website, singaporeidol.com, for more details. So, Jai and Ken still not talking, huh? Okay, Dan, over to you. All right. I wonder what's going on there. Anyways, it's Ong and Leong. Check this out. It's Jonathan Leong. Okay, John, what's a typical National Day activity like in the Leong household?
A typical National Day would be that my family goes to my godfather's house and we have dinner and we watch the parade together.
Wow, very chilled out, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Now, what does he like to do on National Day? Well, check this out.
My most memorable National Day experience was in 2002 when I was still serving my national service and my group of friends and I were told to do the National Day parade. It was really fun because I got to see the parade from a different perspective. I usually watch it at home, you know, with my family. We were always sunburned because every Saturday we would go under the sun and we were wearing the parade. So we went home with our faces red and our necks red, but everything else was still normal. So it was really weird. Tonight I'm singing Dance With My Father because this is a very special song to me and every time I hear it, you know, it reminds me of my father's love for me. It touches my heart and I hope it touches yours too.
Dance With My Father by Luther Vandross was of course a tribute to his late father. Singing it tonight, Jonathan Leong.
Outside her door, and I'd hear how my mother dear Lord, she's dying to dance with my father again.
Well, it was nice to see another side of you today, quieter side. Only thing, it was a bit boring. A little bit boring. I didn't really get the emotion. And remember, your voice is quite low, and when you sing light like this, it sounds quite muffled. Doesn't sound clear, yeah.
Jonathan, that was fine, but you know what? I think the magic of Jonathan is that dynamite performer, so please bring him back next week.
Yeah, I always think you have a new dimension to you. This evening, I came up with something different, which was restraint. However, I think you've got to watch the pitching, because for once you took a risk and it didn't quite pay off, but you still got it, man.
Thank you, Jonathan, that was mumbling, that wasn't singing. This is a perfect example of, you know, how you pick the wrong song. You have a very nice tone, you didn't feature it, you know. You can be very charismatic on stage, you didn't do it. So you did everything wrongly this week.
Thanks, Ken.
Jonathan, everybody. So John, do you agree it was a wrong choice of song? Why did you do this song?
Actually, no, I don't agree, because I did this song mainly is for my father. So,
cool,
and,
cool.
I really felt it, so I hope the rest of the viewers do.
I also know that you're trying to sing the song because you want to feature your low voice, right? Which is what happened last week.
Yeah, well, I was trying to do that, but you know, we'll see tomorrow.
Okay, we will. Take his number down if you want to keep in the competition, if you want to dance with him some more. This is his number. It is 1-900-112-1907. Or you can SMS the number 7 to 43657. All right. Everybody, this is Jonathan, and this is Daniel. Why, hello there. And this is Paul Tuchel.
Now, you just went for the NDP preview.
Yep.
What was your favorite moment?
Okay, actually, it's like I went to the toilet to pee, to wee-wee, and then I heard this really loud noise, and then when I went up, woohoo, F-16 fighter pilots, baby.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That was the favorite?
Yeah, that was the best part.
Excellent. He likes his planes. Ooh. Now, when he was much younger, he actually went to the Padang to catch a National Day Parade. Check this out.
Long, long time ago, when Paul Twohill was little, Mom Twohill was being Paul Twohill to the National Day Parade. I remember how hot it was all the time. I'd be like complaining,
"Mommy, so hot, I'm sweating. Who are all these people? I don't like this."
"Quiet, boy." Then I'll be like, "Okay, right." And then when the tanks came out and the soldiers came out and the fighter jets, baby, fighter jets, Paul would just sit there and be quiet. And National Day was always enjoyable because I was with my mommy. Say, the song I chose this week is Bouncy. Upbeat, and it's supposed to make you think about your friends, let you get all fuzzy. It's Pictures of You.
This song by Irish boy band Boys on reach number 2 in the UK charts, singing Picture of You, Paul Twohill.
Told me you were too much to take. I didn't see it, I didn't wanna know. I let you in and you let me down. You messed me up and you turned my life around. Left me feeling I had nowhere to go. I was alone, how was I to know that you'd be there when I needed somebody.
You know, this is the first time in the whole contest that the audience was so quiet while you were singing that it's the first time I really heard what a terrible singer you are. I mean, that was really completely out of tune. I mean, I don't know what happened.
Thank you.
I'm gonna say, Paul, I do like seeing this silly, goofy side of Paul. I think that was nice. But vocally, you were a mess tonight.
Paul, your body language is really great. Mm-hmm. You really blow us away. But your singing, unfortunately, suffered.
Paul, I asked my son who he likes best. Mm-hmm. He said the one with the hair. You see, you are like a character. Mm-hmm. You are novelty. And the only way to survive in this competition is that you don't sound like Joakim.
Paul Twohill.
You smell pretty.
Okay, so do you think you sound like Joakim?
Huh? Joakim might sound different, I guess. I don't know.
Okay.
He has his strengths, I have my strengths, I guess.
Okay.
Some way or another, so...
I like talking to him because he's very animated and then when he talks, the hand goes all over the place. But that's him. And if you want him to come back again for the next round, you got to get his number down. Everybody, his number is 1-900-112-1908. SMS the number 8 to 43657. Everybody, Paul Twohill.
Thank you.
Now, Singapore, all 8 have performed. You can stop tickling me. He was tickling me. He was all 8 have performed, and you can very soon start voting. But here is a quick recap of the performances and their voting numbers.
Take me so long.
arrive at Singapore, I am happy to tell you, cue happy face, the lines are open.
Yeah.
And they stay open till tomorrow night.
Remember, you can vote as many times as you want. Now, you have to vote to keep your favorites in the competition. Now, to get the voting numbers, you can log on SingaporeIdol.com.
Now, let's thank the judges. Singapore Idol judges, give it up for Diggly, Florence, Jacinta, and Ken Lim. Thank you, judges.
Notice, Dan, Ken and Ja are still not speaking to each other.
No.
It's been a... I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. I hope they come back tomorrow. I hope they're friendly, they make up or something. They call each other SMS, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I just hope, you know, somebody does something.
Yeah,
we can't have this.
We can only cross our fingers. We can only cross our fingers.
Also want to thank the people in the house! And the people at home, thank you for joining us and watching Singapore Idol. Also, thank you for joining us on a special day. Happy National Day, Singapore.
Yeah.
We've come to the end of the show. I'm Gurmit.
And I'm Daniel. Remember to catch us on Singapore Idol Extra tomorrow at 8 p.m. and the result show at 8:30 p.m. live on Channel 5. Happy birthday, Singapore!
Happy birthday!
Hey, look, Ken and John.